गुड मॉर्निंग फार्मर फ्रेंड्स, आई वेलकम यू ऑन बिहाफ ऑफ विनवर्ल्ड टीम ऑन दिस प्रेजेंटेशन अबाउट गट हेल्थ इन पोल्ट्री. सो दिस इज अ सीरीज ऑफ लेक्चर्स वी आर अरेंजिंग फॉर यू टू हैव अ बेटर प्रोडक्टिविटी एंड लेस प्रॉब्लम्स इन योर पोल्ट्री फार्मिंग. सो दिस प्रेजेंटेशन इज अबाउट मेकिंग फाउंडेशन ऑफ गट हेल्थ इन पोल्ट्री. एक्चुअली व्हाई वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट गट हेल्थ इन पोल्ट्री इज बिकॉज the gut or intestinal tract or digestive system of the bird, if you look at the organ to body ratio of gut is very very large in poultry, very very wide actually, because such a small organ which is feeding to the big body of the poultry of the bird, and then efficiency of that gut is very very important because it is a complex area which combines nutrition, microbiology, immunology and physiology. So all these functions are taken place in the gut health. So this is a very important organ actually to look into and to be serious about. So when we see that after the hatch, the gut matures through first 11 days as villi fully develop. So the villi development, intestinal villus crypt depth and height, it fully develops by 11th day. And maximum development at 4 days in duodenum and 10 days in jejunum and ileum happens. So in this, if you see, there are certain indicators that your gut function, your bird's gut function is performing well or not. So what are those indicators? So first is that poor growth rate, variation, flock uniformity will not be good, weight feces and weight litter, feed passage will be rampant, and frothy sickle droppings will be there, as we have shown here in the pictures here. So such situations may arise. So gut is also related with the immunity. How it is, that we will see. So gut health and immunity, actually gut gastrointestinal tract or gut, it contains 70% of bird's immune cells. They are called as a gut associated lymphoid tissues, and it is the intestine, it is the site of interaction between microbes, feed and the immune system. So in this gut associated lymphoid tissues, as I told that it plays a major role in providing immune cells and their products to defend against pathogenic invasion. So this is also a very important function, that it plays important role in deciding the immunity of the bird. So why these gut associated lymphoid tissues are important? Actually, they have the largest number of plasma cells, which are very important in producing antibodies for the bird. So the number of the plasma cells is so high as compared to the spleen, lymph nodes and bone marrow. It is very 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 high number in the of the plasma cells in the GALT. Right. So this regulation of gastrointestinal tract function is a multifactorial phenomena. In that, there are three important factors which decides the gut function. The first important thing is that balanced nutrition has to be there. The second is a structural and functional integrity of gastrointestinal barrier. It is very much important. And the microbiota host interaction, proper eco-balance in the gut is important. So in this, today we are going to see about microbiota and host interaction, how it happens and how important it is for the bird's health. So this microbiota or this intestinal flora, what we call it, what are the functions of intestinal flora? That question will arise in your mind. So this intestinal microflora has different roles in bird's body. The fermentation of nutrients, it is the first role, as degradation of starch to produce lactic acid and decreases local pH. So that happens. Then protection against the pathogens due to lower pH and high lactic acid percentage, the gram negative bacteria count goes down, and again reinforcement of intestinal barrier mucosa, it also happens, and stimulation of digestive immune system is the outcome of that. And in natural condition, if you see that a country bird or its brood, you might not have seen that any chicks is dying due to disease or something like that in that brood. Why? Because so some scientists have studied on that, and it happens only because of the gut flora which the chicks receive, the brood receives from the mother hen, that plays very much important in deciding the disease prevention ability of that bird or those chicks. So that's why these chicks, they do not die so frequently, and they are apparently healthy. And what about artificial incubation? Because our hatcheries, they are almost sterile. There are no infection load or pathogenic load in normal conditions. They are maintained good. So that what happens? There is no exposure of this microflora to these chicks, or the positive microflora, I can say in better way. So it is not there. So in this sterile environment, so there is no exposure to the microflora, and then definitely that gut flora, which needs to be developed in the chick's body, it doesn't happen over there. So we have a solution for that, which is called as IV flora, which can be a strong foundation of gut health. So why IV flora? It is a unique concept, actually. Concept, we can say, not only a product. This IV flora is a different to a probiotics because it contains the entire cecal microflora. Almost around 200 species of bacteria are there in this product, which are taken and isolated from the adult SPF chicken. So how it works? Actually, IV flora works through competitive exclusion, which prevents the colonization of transient enteropathogens such as E. coli, Clostridia, Salmonella, etc. And IV flora colonizes the gut in and compete with potential enteropathogens. So competitive exclusion means what? Survival of the fittest, we can say. Suppose first drop of food or water, whatever it goes in the chick's body, so it will have the authority to develop itself, the microbiota whichever is going inside the chick's body. So it has the authority to develop as a first come first serve basis, so that they will, suppose unfortunately the pathogenic microflora goes inside, it will propagate. And if we are giving IV flora, then the this competitive exclusion will happen, pathogenic microflora will not be there, and all the positive bacteria which are helpful for the bird, it will propagate inside the body. And it the working pattern of the IV flora, it goes like this. So when this beneficial microflora takes upper hand, definitely the pathogenic microflora will be taken out of the body through competitive exclusion mechanism. So there are some scientific validation for this product also. So suppose if natural habitat, if you look at on day 7, the taxonomy of the bird look like this. So it is there in the figure, and this is the taxonomy of the microflora which generally present in the bird. And on day 11 it is like this. So when we give IV flora to the bird on day 7, it is almost matching as like a natural habitat. And on day 11, full development will happen, full microflora will be identical with the bird which are reared in a natural condition. So it has a beneficial effect over Salmonella, pathogenic Salmonella, pathogenic bacteria is fed, is fed. So it has shown better effect against the Salmonella when IV flora is given on day 1st. Percent cecal excretion has come down there. And then about Clostridia also, if you look at, when we compare the efficacy of IV flora and different antibiotic growth promoters against necrotic enteritis in broiler, if you look at here, this is control group, IV flora group, virginiamycin and bacitracin has been given for the different groups. And at 21 and 28 days, so it is studied that mean lesion score of IV flora group is 1.3 and 0.7, and virginiamycin group was 1.4 and 0.7. And bacitracin group was 2 and 1.6. So it shows that IV flora is far, far better than the antibiotic group. And mortality percentage also, if you look at, in the IV flora group, absolutely there is no mortality. And in virginiamycin group, 2.1% mortality was found. And in bacitracin, 0.7% mortality. So this flop was given with oral gavage with Clostridium perfringens, the causative organism for necrotic enteritis, and we found that significant improvement with IV flora, lower lesion score and reduced mortality. This study was done in Georgia University. Effects of IV flora on the cecal colonization of day old chicks by pathogenic E. coli versus IV flora. So when we look at here, most pathogenic strain of E. coli O78 and K80 was taken for the trial, and in that, if you see, so on day 7 and day 14 there is a significant log reduction of E. coli against the control group. So this Avigard is the international name of IV flora product, so that has come here. So, and then next our trial was in the commercial broilers actually. So, the birds which are fed on aviflora and on normal basal diet, and birds which challenged with E. coli and given aviflora on day one. So, if you look at these two groups has almost around similar performances, and coli count was also significantly reduced as compared to the control and exposed group of E. coli. So this is about the histopathology study of that those broilers. So duodenal section has been taken, and it is showing that fully developed villi and normal architecture has been found in aviflora group here. And then again in the group where E. coli challenge was there and aviflora was given, here also significant development in the villi and normal architecture was found, and crypt depth was also almost normal. So again the trial was taken about the gut development of the chicks after 2 days, how it happens when the aviflora is given. There are two observations in that. In this GI tract, or what we can call it as an the organ study when we have done, so you can find that there is a full absorption of yolk, and then bulkiness of the intestine that is showing that the activity was already activated. And other two groups, the yolk absorption is also not proper. And then gut activity also, it is almost around insignificant. It is not that significant here. So how do we recommend this product and when to give? This for commercial broilers on day one, through oral or big dipping, it has to be given. Suppose in broiler, antibiotics are given. So first 3 days antibiotic you can give for therapeutic use. And then day four and five, clean water has to be given. And day 6, aviflora has to be given. Then on commercial layers and breeders, day 1 first dose has to be given, second dose approximately 15 weeks after your antimycoplasma program and along with MG killed vaccine. So you can give that, and third dose 40 weeks after MG killed vaccine is given. Then what are the benefits of aviflora? Aviflora protects the birds against Salmonella species, necrotic enteritis caused by Clostridium perfringens, and it gives protection against the pathogenic E. coli. And in addition to that, 97% reduction in use of antibiotics, 0.41% reduction in rejects, 0.44% reduction in final mortality, and your flock will be Salmonella free. I can say that it can be a good tool when you are planning a antibiotic free program for your birds, particularly in broiler. So this product is available in packs of 2000 doses, 5000 doses and 10000 doses, and storage recommendation is 2 to 8 degrees Celsius. This product is stored, transported and administered in cold chain. So whenever you are giving this product aviflora to the bird, it has to be ensured that the water has to be cool. And in the chicks when you are giving, you can give it in the normal saline or vaccine diluent. And big dipping can be done or oral drop can be given. So this was all about, I wanted to talk about having a strong foundation for gut health for your chicken. So thank you so much for listening patiently.